Hello, Zitter Hit, and welcome back to Godfall. So, let's continue, actually, where is the guy? There he is.
So this is the inside of a sanctum.
She's quite something. Though, I did not expect her to be so independent.
She's a living being, Auron. Not merely some weapon to be wielded.
Well, in that case, I'll have to look to you for the weapons.
You never change. I'll provide you with basic arms. The rest we can forge. Here, this will help.
A sacred flame.
Go on. Light the forge with it.
So visit the forge. Guessing assisting?
You'll be able to upgrade your equipment once we gather the right materials.
Forge. You've rekindled the forge. Upgrade your equipment with resources to improve your stats. It can be upgraded up to 5 times. Enchant your equipment to improve its rarity, augment, and common items cannot be enchanted. But I'm guessing a bull arm can. Or a legendary sword, longsword. Well, I think about this, this is a legendary. But eventually I'll outrank this completely. Amulets. And I can't use the augments yet. But you can also increase the augments. Oh, you can. Oh, this also shows you what you get for salvaging. Dragon steel. Oh, to enchant it, I need dragon steel. So it looks like I need to sacrifice the lower versions. So it doesn't look like I can mass salvage. So if I look at this, so these you can't enchant. You only get electrum. So let's salvage that. That's a weapon you can't salvage. So that's probably the starting weapon. So salvage this. This gives me sun steel. For the uncommon versions. You just get rid of all the uncommons. Is there a way? I don't know. I think from the other menu it's easier. It just gives you a bunch of sun steel for uncommons. So 3 for this one, and upgrading would be I need dragon steel. So even the red ones need dragon steel. But it looks like you can only get them from epic and higher equipment. We'll probably fight them in a level. Yeah, this is all sun steel. What is it level requirement? Probably not. That's strange. This weapon you can upgrade just with a vector. Let's just do this. See what happens. So, only damage is increased. Now it's electrum and sun steel. Still, only the damage is increased by little. Incarnate essence. Yeah, I don't think I'm willing to use that yet. That's only damage increasing. I have a few points. That's not really useful. What's the requirements for these? Crystalline tears? What's that? Infused Jeff Greyhawk. Soulshatter build up. Unleash a shockwave that applies 74 Soulshatter build up to nearby enemies. 100% Soulshatter build up. Blurring Hawk on Fury. Unleash a shockwave that applies. Oh, it's like. It's contaminating the others. Oh, that's neat. But I can actually get this one. So, White Knight looking thing, just the one I have. I can also get the Bulwark. Summon two physical sentinels. During Archon Fury, get a 90% chance to inflict bleed. 100% damage to bleeding enemies. Your attack deals physical damage. What's this one? Oh, that requires Etheric Filament. There's so many of these. Crystalline Tears. Etheric Filament. Another Filament. Orb of Oblivion. Oh, here's another one. Mesa. 10% chance to inflict poison. Unleash a shockwave that deals 54 earth damage. During Arc of Fury, 90% chance to inflict poison. 100% damage to poisoned enemies. Your attack deal earth damage. And... oh, that's the starting guy. Oh, that's the equipment. Let's have three possible affinities. Red, green and blue. They can only slot into neutral or matching nodes. Each augment has a power drain amount. Your total power drain cannot exceed your other player's power capacity. Oh, you can't use any in this one. So it looks like you need a certain affinity. So should it just go... okay, let's get this one.
The armor of Focus was most commonly worn by younger warriors seeking to hone their skills.
So let's see. Copy current loadout. Yeah, that works. Let's look at augments. How do they get affinity? Like, the game hasn't said anything about affinity. Let's try to equip this one. Yeah, that looks neat. Well, it has a cape.
It's good you found Xenon. He'll be useful.
He's also a friend of yours.
We're at war. You and I only have time for those we find useful.
Perhaps. Usefulness comes after care, Auron.
What I care about is defeating Makros. If Xenon can help us do that, so much the better.
From an Earth sigil we acquired at the Vargal Fortress, I've been able to locate Zamora the Farseeing. She's at her lair behind the Prismatic Falls. You need to acquire enough Earth sigils, including the one we already have, before we can enter her lair. You can earn them by completing hunt missions here in the Earth Realm.
So let's accept. Instead of anything escape and not hear the entire story. So. What's this? Alpha Record Hunt. Oh, you can do hunts. So facing the Alpha Rancor will be a formidable task, but will prove you are ready for what lies ahead. Two Earth Sigils, one Rare Eye Flightstone, complete optional objectives to earn bonus rewards. That's level 6, that's level 7. That's locked. So that's level requirement 9. So that's the objective I need to go at. I could try to level up with this one. Yeah, let's do this one. Great music. We need to breach enemies. Oh, this is a blind mission? Well, he died. Spin is a little slow. Actually, it's a spear or a polearm. That's a pretty nice range. But it's mostly linear. Well, I say linear. Low level weapon. A lodestone. So basically I have 43 minutes. So it's longer than most missions that I've been running on. That's dangerous. This is way harder than I thought it would be. Come on, Soul Shatter. Let's do a weapon change. And he got away. Oh no, it's not Soul Shed, I need to breach enemies. Well, I need to use a death blow. I haven't been able to do that one yet. These guys are gonna kill me at one point. How do I hit those? That hurts. I really have no clue how to do the death blow. So I can see the weak points. That triggered too late. Also, I'm stuck on the enemy. And level. Well, I've reached an enemy. No. Let's try this. is not a normal enemy. Are they giving him shields? Yeah, that healer is a problem. Also, he's countering my attacks. Oh, that gives me a bunch of goodies. Hell yeah. But I'm kind of out of healing things. Like, this mission was way harder than I thought it would be. That feels like my weapons aren't dealing enough damage now. Oh, that's a skill. So, weak points. So, that's weak point damage. Let's actually get health regeneration. Aimwood and resistance. Oh, resistances? That might be an interesting one. At least if it can help with my survivability, hell yeah. I've been using way too many healing things. Oh, it works. Let's get this thing. Oh, the ticket. So, is it dependent on where I'm aiming? I think it's trick-based. It only triggered when I hit him on the last time. That really felt like it was time-based. I'm still taking way too much damage. And he teleported. On this mission. Well, that's some healing. Oh, that's the Alpha Rancor. So any weapons that I am are actually stronger? 34... I don't think so. Fight ASP. Just polarity attacks. They're a higher level. But they're not stronger. Yeah, the melee hit me. Wait, why is my shield not activating?
No.
I was literally holding the Q button. It was like, nope. That's how that works. Oh, that's poison. So, what's this movement? He likes this dagger like crazy. Yeah, he's outside of my range. When he doesn't. Oh, that's a hit point. What a weak point. That's not fast enough. I don't defend. No. I might die again. Oh. Well.
We can always try again.
Yeah, he's way stronger. I'm all the way back here. It does feel like that. He immediately turned around. His attack speed is so fast. Yeah, no way to counter. He's only using red attacks now. That's a long range attack. No, he's stumbling. He's immediately attacking me. Oh shit. That missed. I'm about to die. This guy really doesn't give you much time to counter. You. Looks like dodging is really the way to go with this guy. Oh, going flying again. Well, that's not what I was trying to do. At least I know it's better now. That should hurt. That was way harder than I thought it would be. I'm actually done with this level. That's not too bad. What's that? Lodestone. A rare one. Let's see what this does. Ooh, 93 health recovery. Primary effect, 10 seconds. 40 plus 43% physical damage. Plus 14% weak point damage. Oh, that's actually a bit better, I think. Yeah, that's level 6. And this one comes close to the other weapons now. So let's exchange it for this one. And I don't have the stuff to upgrade it. So yeah. So that's it for this episode. So thank you for watching and hope to see you in the next one.